It was a roller coaster. We would take it in turns being emotional. Like, I'm generally pretty emotional,
yeah,
so
just talking to you.
I'd be up and down, and Lindsay would, you know, pull me through it, and we're going to get through it, you know. And then the next day she'd be down, and I'd be like, no, we're all good, we're all good. So it worked really well. We actually worked as a team pretty well, which was good. But it was just, yeah, roller coaster. We managed the water quite well in the end and survived it. But the drop from the search and rescue team, they were just amazing. From when we set off the beacon, it was about 4 hours before the plane flew overhead, and it dropped the satellite phone to us. And from that moment, we felt pretty well safe.
Yeah, then it was like, people know where we are. They're like really helpful.
They let us talk to our families, and just they would check in with us every, you know, 3 times a day just to make sure we're all good.
Yeah.
First night in the desert, there was a massive storm. Big low pressure cell came through and just hosed down.
It was the worst storm we've ever had.
Yeah.
Like we thought like the roof might blow off. It was just, it was a crazy storm.
And we've camped through a cyclone before, so this was like felt worse, felt scarier. So then we sort of, we were told, you know, if it rains, sit still, but we were still able to move forward. We weren't sure whether to go forward or backwards, and we kept going. Basically, we got to the point where on the third day when it was hitting those mud flats, that was pretty much where we knew that we were in a bit of trouble.
It was after we'd finished the Simpson.
Yeah, well,
we got out of the Simpson Desert, like, technical part.
Yeah.
And then we were like, oh, yeah, not far to Dalhousie. And we were pretty excited. And then, we saw how wet the flats were.
Yeah.
And that's when we're like,
that's when we realised. And you don't have enough fuel to get back through the desert back to Birdsville. So you've either got to push forward or wait it out, and you know, we've been told that it can be weeks before that dries out, so just had to push forward. Probably made a few little decisions that were wrong, but yeah, once the trucks sort of started to sink down, we knew that it was, I knew that we were in trouble. Lindsay still had hope that we could dig it out, and you know,
stuck for 5 hours. I was like, we're getting out of this, we're fine.
But yeah, once we saw how deep the axles were actually buried, it was then the decision to send off the beacon and wait for help, basically.
I think we called ahead and we checked the roads, you know, or we did all the research and that, but we just didn't expect that much rain that quickly.
And for it to have that much of an effect for such a long time.
Yes.
Like, we knew that our kids were safe. We would never put them in a situation... I don't think we would have put them in a situation where they were unsafe, so...
I've had a lot more experiences than the other kids their age.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, we think that as long as we kept them safe, I don't think anything would have happened.
No.
But you just never know. You can only prepare so much for things. Like, we could be driving down the road and get hit by a bus and... So we wouldn't change what we do. The kids certainly get a lot of experience from our travels. So
yeah.
I think we wouldn't change that for the world. Maybe try and be a little bit more prepared next time. I don't know. Yeah, they did really well to get us pretty much what we asked for though.
Yeah,
really
it was, and that was a relief because then we knew we definitely had enough. Like they said, they wanted us to be able to last another 10 days just in case. So that was nice. And
water as well. They dropped a lot of water as well.
What was the kind of the best thing once you landed that you got to do that you've been waiting to do for 5 days?
Wash my hair.
Have a beverage.
Oh yeah, have a drink too. Yeah.
Definitely. We didn't have much beer in the truck at all.
We have a drinks fridge in the truck, and we drank it before we left, and then I filled it with water for the Simpson. Just
very smart.
Just to be careful. Yeah, so we only had three cans of beer. Yeah, and that's all we had the whole time. But, you know, people have it a lot worse, so I can't complain. But I enjoyed my wine last night.
Yeah, I had a rum. We want to keep doing trips, whether it's travelling full time or doing 6 month trips or 3 month trips. We don't know yet.
Same with the setup. We don't know whether we'll get a new setup, whether we'll build something, or whether we'll
build something different. Who knows?
Yeah. buy something? I don't know. Yes. We know as much as you on that one. I don't know.
We know we love traveling.
Yeah. We've had the best
great
year.
For the kids, so if we can do that in some way, shape, or form, we will. But yeah, we definitely want to go back to Perth and reset, see the family.
Because everyone has been really invested in what you guys have been doing. What would you like to say to everyone?
Thank you. Thank you to everyone that supported us. The South Australian Police Department, the search and rescue team.
And everyone we know, because obviously the people that we spoke to, personally, and we want to thank all of those, but then there's all the others that work behind the scenes just to make everything work and happen and get us out as quickly as possible. I know it was a big effort and there was a lot of logistics involved. So really, really, really thank them all, every single one of them, hugely.
And all the messages, all the private messages from people just wishing us well.
Yeah, that's been lovely to come out to all those messages. Yeah.
But another message to everyone, don't let this deter you from doing a trip like this. It's an adventure. It's all part of it. It is what it is. It's not ideal.
Go see Australia.
Yeah.
Yeah. And yeah, that I was going to say, no regrets.
No regrets.
No regrets. Never. Never any regrets. There's definitely decisions we could have made different, but no regrets.